Hi, I'm super excited today because I have this really good friend of mine, a fantastic colleague, a person who I've been looking up to when I used to be look up at, because one, she's really very tall, she's damn pretty, damn talented, has a voice to die for. She is already...
She's kind of high
now. No, wait. Of course, ladies and gentlemen, presentez-vous, Andrea Jeremiah. பா ஒரே தமிழ் பொண்ணு தமிழ் கலாச்சாரத்தோட அப்படி எப்படி ததும்ப வந்திருக்கீங்க. எப்படி இருக்கீங்க ஆண்ட்ரியா?
நான் நல்லா இருக்கேன், சௌக்கியமா இருக்கேன். நீங்க எப்படி இருக்கீங்க?
ரொம்ப சௌக்கியமா இருக்கேன். ஸோ ஆண்ட்ரியா ஹேஸ் ஹேட் திஸ் ரீசன்ட் ப்ராக்டிஸ் டு ஆக்சுவலி சென்ட் வணக்கம் இந்த மார்னிங்,
காலை வணக்கம்,
காலை வணக்கம். அண்ட் ஷி சென்ஸ் தட் இன் தமிழ் ஸ்கிரிப்ட், இமேஜின், அண்ட் ஐ சே குட் மார்னிங். ஸோ தட்ஸ் ஹவு வி ஆர். ஸோ வாட்ஸ் வித் திஸ் சென்டிங் text in Tamil recently, and
someone put the script on my phone.
Oh
yeah,
and you just decided you'll start off with that.
I like to shock people now and then.
So we used to be doing this Tamil television reality show together, and we had a ball of time, especially because of this lady here. And before that, I worked with her for the first time at the UN Shankaraja US tour last year, and it was fun. We yes. discovered food, we discovered a lot of things. I discovered what a nice, lovely human being, highly professional.
Also made me discover Sephora.
Wait, that I'm coming to. Okay, so Andrea is a really professional person. You tell her that, listen, this is what it is, you will wait for 2 hours, she'll silently wait for 2 hours. 2 hours and 10 minutes, you take more time, you're not professional, she's going to whoop your ass.
Yeah, that's true.
This is okay, I'm going to beep that out. She's gonna come and whoop your behind. Okay, now I also took her to Sephora where she was very overwhelmed. She was like, I'm palpitating, I'm breathing too hard. So I can't actually begin as to how that went. So please experience. Tell me about your experience at Sephora with me.
Well, I feel like you should tell the story.
No, I think you should. I've been yapping too much. I'm sure your fans are already... I'm sure the viewers should
well,
this video.
Well, the thing is that I'm not as aware of makeup and products as Madam Chinmay here. So, when we were in the US and I wanted to go and eat ice cream, but Chinmay took me to Sephora.
Okay. Where were we?
Vegas. In that big mall that... and then after that we went and had ice cream, I remember.
The ice cream thing was on the way. Were we in Vegas?
We were in Vegas.
So we were in Vegas.
Yeah, we were in Vegas.
So where, I think it was one of those...
It was that mall in the hotel at the Caesar Palace.
Correct. Caesar's Palace had a Sephora inside. So we had to cross an ice cream parlor and she was like, ice cream! It was like Sephora! So
it was a tough call.
So that's what we did. We eventually ended up having ice cream.
And I had a nervous breakdown almost. She because did. It was too many things. How do people know what to buy?
Yes. So that's when thankfully I was around. Unfortunately, I ditched her for a little bit of a time. And she
then
was
the sales girl was like, oh, we should get this. We should get that. We should get this.
Help me. She was literally like, help. Save me. Rescue me from this. So finally, I think she picked up an hourglass ambient light, and then she
it was nice.
It was nice. See, it was nice. And then she also picked up the Urban Decay's some.
Oh yeah, that moon dust palette.
Yes, the moon dust palette.
I use it for my shoes.
See,
shimmery, shimmery stuff.
Yes, and keep quiet, please. Please keep quiet. So tell me, do you actually like using makeup?
I think of it as a job thing. So I am not someone who wakes up and makes up my face.
What a life.
What a slow clap
I'm
moment.
I'm not a
wake up and make up person. Hey, that's really impressive. I just came up with that. I did not think about that. Anyway, getting back to the point, I'm not a wake up and make up sort of person because I'm lazy, number one. Really, and I guess at some level I'm a believer of the go natural sort of philosophy. Mm-hmm. But of course, as an actor and as a performer on stage, you cannot expose your skin to the evils out there. Basically, lights and more lights. So, and of course, when you need to look good and you need to accentuate your features and things like that, makeup comes in handy.
Yes.
But otherwise, sunscreen.
Yes, sunscreen, sunscreen and more sunscreen. What do you use? Which is your favorite sunscreen?
I use Shiseido.
Mm-hmm. Is that been only the one?
Yeah, someone has put me onto it a few years ago. And as I have mentioned, I am quite ignorant of products and also lazy. So if someone gives me something, I just keep using it till someone else comes along and tells me something I use. Then I like that.
So today, what I'm going to be doing with Andrea is I have been literally bombarding her with... So during our US tour, I gave her some sheet masks, which she really liked.
Yes. I like that part because that's cool. Like, you just put it and you just chill.
So I think Andrea is more like this no nonsense, less fussy. Give me a sheet mask and I'm sorted, sort of a one step skincare sort of a person. Today I'm going to be using my Defiderm app on someone else, and that's going to be Andrea, and we're going to be analyzing her skin. And she is saying that she's been nervous.
Okay, we shall check it out to see how her skin works.
Okay,
and see, we'll suggest what works for you.
An app?
Yes, and this is the device.
Oh my God.
It's cool, no? So you guys have already seen my Defiderm video where I've used this device and the app and tell you how I go about it. So I am a skincare junkie, so I go about using stuff like this just because I feel like it. So now, what you do, this one will click like this. You just press it up. So forehead, under the eye and on the cheek. So you'll do that. Go.
So which part has to touch my skin, the white part or the black
no,
part?
No, both. It'll be flat. So
complete. Can you do it? I don't know what to do.
Okay.
I'm also technologically challenged.
All right, baby. Yeah. So this is going to, don't crinkle your forehead.
Okay. Oh, I thought it was going to like prick or something.
Okay.
Am I failing? I don't know.
Not yet.
I'm scared.
Failing, it seems.
I don't know.
So her forehead's reading has been done, and oh, that's not bad at all, my dear. Oh wait, let's redo this. This is not for the cheek.
Why are they coming in three different colors?
Because it's three different zones.
Oh, so it's not like a pass fail color code. I don't know, I'm just asking.
Okay, so now that's done. I'm going to show you your skin analysis, my dear. Your overall hydration level is average, okay?
That's so sad.
Okay, overall I saw that mostly you failed in the hydrations. You have not put in enough moisturizer. And with skin pigmentation, it's medium.
Okay.
It's okay. It's fine. That means that you may tan easily, but you may also get red in the sun or get a sunburn as well.
That is true.
Your skin is very sensitive to UV rays, even if it doesn't look like it.
It is very
okay?
sensitive.
So you must regularly apply and reapply sunscreen.
Sunscreen.
Your skin health and oxygen levels are average. Your skincare routine is not optimized yet.
Oh no!
The following ingredients will help you enhance your routine for the better. Peptides, vitamin E, macadamia seed oil, and avocado oil. So I'm going to be giving you some products which I think will help for you. Okay?
Okay.
All right. So in my opinion, because it says...
I'm a failure.
Yaare endu solravari, you are a failure. I think your fans will come at me and probably crash this channel and report this video for abuse or something like that. Can you imagine that? Yes. So...
I feel like we should do a hair test now.
No need. I think your hair is great. You know that, which is why you're even saying that. See, she has naturally dense hair. She does not need any extensions, unlike me. And she has never colored her hair.
That's true.
And her hair is really healthy, you know?
Yeah.
I think that this video is really entertaining. You bring that extra something to this really... very dull channel.
Maybe I drink too much coffee. Is that the reason why my skin is not hydrated enough?
No.
Oh.
You're not moisturizing it enough. You also.
But that's not true. I do.
So clearly your moisturizer is not optimized.
I started using oils on my skin.
Okay. So they are lipids. They are not literally moisturizers. Skincare science. I've been reading up on that a little bit. So what I'm going to be giving you today is I really like this... Korean skincare brand called Pyeongkang Yul. Okay, Priyankang Yul. So okay. They are.
I shan't try to say that.
Yes. So Priyankang Yul is somebody. If you have been following K Beauty, you know that the Essence Toner is a superstar in the recent times, and they are an Oriental medical clinic, and their skincare comes with very very simple 3-4 ingredient formulations, and with very safe ingredients. So that's what I'm going to be giving Andrea today. Okay. So this you shall.
Do not to wash my face first.
Just apply it on your.
It's really okay. Cool.
Yes, it is.
Like it feels cool.
Now, once
I
you
don't
finish
want to
this,
waste this. Like, do you
no, mind? Don't. No, put it up on your face. Okay. I'll tell you. I shall show you your now changed readings once this is done and has been absorbed by your skin.
But shouldn't? Oh, okay.
Shouldn't what?
Do not have to wash my face first.
I asked you to wash your face before you came. Did you or no?
But I was wearing a little sunscreen.
Now you tell me. Munji alvina ketena illaya.
Only sunscreen.
You said I'm not wearing anything, so I don't need to wash.
Yeah, I was only wearing sunscreen. I thought sunscreen is allowed. No, it's not allowed.
It's okay.
Okay.
Fine.
Okay. I feel like it's absorbed kind of.
Yeah, so it absorbs pretty quickly.
Okay. Mm.
And the next would be your moisture ampoule.
What is an ampoule exactly? Is this it like a serum? Is it like a fancy word for a serum?
No, this is a little more concentrated than a serum because of the yes. The number of
ingredients?
Yes.
Activators.
Well, more or less. You seem to know the right words, my dear.
I'm good at English.
That's true.
Okay.
No, it's herbal medicine clinic, so it's not going to smell. No, let me see.
It's kind of tightening on this. Is it like a tightening effect?
Oh, this actually smells like nothing actually.
I don't know why. Okay. And now what?
And now I'm going to be giving you the cream. And you shall take this home and use this religiously. Okay?
Morning and night or something? No, you can
use it in the night. That's the doubt.
I want to improve the texture and tone of my skin.
I shall help you if you follow my rules.
Yes, ma'am. Headmistress. Ma'am.
All right.
Hey, I like the packaging. It looks really
yes, it's
cool.
Beautiful, no?
It's beautiful.
Me too. Very simplistic.
Yeah.
And minimalist.
I like that.
And I think this moisture cream would be great before your makeup because this is very hydrating.
So, what about my oils then? Can't use them?
Oils are more for nighttime.
Oh, I didn't know that.
So, I'm going to be analyzing her skin after we put in the essence toner, the ampoule and the moisture cream from Priyankang Yul. So, let's go with the forehead. The hydration was 23, now it is...
It's not showing
up. Yeah.
How is it possible?
Well, the product works. As simple as that.
Or maybe, okay.
Maybe what?
Oh my god.
Your eye hydration was actually very good automatically.
I didn't put anything there.
So I don't think there'll be much of a difference. It's gone up a little bit, like 0.5. So, my dear, your skin health has actually gone up with just one single usage. So if you continue using this, it'll work.
I will glow.
Yes, you will. In your car.
But I have started my new scrub routine of orange peel powder and yogurt and honey. It's really nice.
So listen to that. This is DIY. This is from Andrea's Kitchen. Orange peel powder.
Orange peel powder. What did I say?
Honey.
Yogurt and honey.
So what does it do for your skin?
Because my skin is becoming excessively dry, I thought instead of using my face wash excessively, let me replace one face wash usage with this.
Wow.
So every morning, I wake up and I mix the orange peel powder. Because whenever I have orange juice, blah, 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 the peels are just out there. So you dry it out in the sun and then you powder it. And mix a little bit of powder with some yogurt and a little bit of honey. And apply the paste on your face and let it dry in 20 minutes and then your instant brightening effect.
See, from they're really pretty, Andrea herself. Now, I'm going to show you something that I have been creating for a while.
you shall be the first person to use it. It is.
So I have been working on this jade roller for a little while, and I worked with a jeweler friend of mine, and I created this jade roller, and this girl is already playing with it, literally. So now let me show you how to use this, my dear.
What is the small one for?
Around the eyes.
Yes. You know, I have under eye, like
puffiness.
No puffiness. Just dark.
So this might actually help
sleep well.
Yes.
Yeah. That's
so much. Roll upwards.
Mm-hmm. Oh my god.
Why is it cold?
It's a little ticklish.
What is it
ticklish?
Dude, I want people to buy this. You can't do this. Oh god. This is such a bad idea. Okay.
It's really cool to the touch.
Okay. This is first impressions, by the way. She's
it's
test driving.
It's like ice, dude.
Yeah, so jade will be, any gemstone will be cooler than the normal temperature. That's
how much of pressure does one
that's
exert?
That's up to you. You can exert a little more pressure if you feel like it. So this will help.
This is fun. I can like do this, you know, only like on the phone and like, listen, I need this done, okay? But I'll be rolling on the side.
Yes! That is the point!
That's so cool!
That's
like yelling at somebody on the phone, like, yeah. How can you do this to me? What is wrong with you? But I'm rolling. That's awesome! That's awesome! Don't try this on the treadmill, though. I would say that would be hazardous to health.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Take her word for it.
I would say so.
So, when you're closer to the eyes, roll it this way.
It's really cold.
Yeah, so eventually it'll start warming up and take up your own body temperature.
So cute this is, dude. I want one. Really?
So I'll give you one.
Yeah. So I can be like a little jade princess. Well, if I want to do so another thing I have to admit that I'm very against cosmetic surgery. So for my dark circles, a lot of people say, oh, why don't you go fillers? But I don't want anything poking
necessary.
My face. Ever. Never. I don't want anything poking my face.
You have a really pretty face. You don't have to.
Yeah, but it's amazing that this is something I guess I should talk about. That I think I'm a pretty above average looking woman.
Excuse me?
Okay. Average looking woman. And yet, so many people, including makeup artists, like, oh, you know, why don't you do your lips? Why don't you do some fillers for your under eyes? I'm like, I'm not touching my lips. I don't want to do anything to my face. Thank you very much. My face may not be perfect. I may not have the most perfect, like, pouty lips. I don't care because I want what's on my face to be mine. So simple. And I feel very strongly about that, actually.
And so there is pressure for actresses to do cosmetic surgery, is it?
I don't know if they... I mean, if you call that pressure, that's not pressure. It's somebody's opinion. That's it. How is it pressure? Somebody has an opinion. Everybody is entitled to an opinion. Everybody is entitled to think what they think about your face. But it's up to you to take it or to let it go. It's not pressure. How can it be pressure?
Interesting.
I think so. Yeah. I mean, that's just the way I feel about it. And I feel I'm not against people doing cosmetic surgery. I mean, obviously, if somebody has an acid attack and they need to do, you know, they need to do skin grafting, that's a very, very real reason to do cosmetic surgery, and I'm totally for that. Or if somebody has breathing problems and they have to correct a deviated septum, go for it, you know. Or if you have a cleft and you have to correct it because you can't chew properly, I think that's probably why the origins of cosmetic surgery came into being, for things like that. And now people are just playing with it, possibly, in this ridiculous search for perfection, which is, you're never going to be as perfect as you want to be. And when you get there, you'll be too perfect to be real. That's the truth, isn't it? But anyway, in terms of cosmetic surgery, especially when it comes to actors, I really, really, really wish actors who do cosmetic surgery on themselves are open about it. Because it's only fair. It's like an athlete taking steroids and running a race and then saying, oh, I ran on my own. It's all me. No, it wasn't. It was the steroids. You know? So when you're doing cosmetic surgery to your face and suddenly looking unattainably perfect on screen, women out there need to know that you didn't wake up looking like that. You have a moral responsibility to tell people, yes, I helped myself with some Botox and some whatever it is, fillers and blah, 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 blah. You owe it to them because I think that is a moral responsibility. That's my take on cosmetic surgery.
You know, I was telling you about this concept of makeup shaming, of this concept of, you know, people who take the effort to look good or they do something or they apply makeup or they dress well, and such girls are generally shamed. So how would you ask these girls or tell these girls to deal with it?
I don't know. I mean, I've never experienced this,
I understand.
I guess, because I don't generally wear makeup. But to each his own. I mean, it's your face. You're entitled to do whatever you want with it. Ultimately, that includes cosmetic surgery. Like I said, my only problem with cosmetic surgery is the lie that usually goes along with it.
Hmm.
Because I don't approve of falsehood or misrepresentation. In terms of makeup shaming, that is quite honestly something new. I've not really come across it. But I can get where you're coming from. Because as a kid, I remember the first time I painted my toenails. That's all I did. I painted my toenails. And my father said, what is that? What are you painting your toenails for? Who are you trying to impress? And I was like, what? I mean, it's toenails. But I can see where you're coming from.
Exactly where I was coming from.
I get it. People think that all women dress up just so that they can get the attention of a man. But sometimes a woman dresses up just because she wants to feel good about herself. And that's just as important, if not more important, than, you know, looking good for your man.
So,
looking good for yourself is as important as looking good for your man.
I have a response to that because I have got this response before. So, I shared a quote on Instagram. I think Emma Stone said it. And she said something like, there's nothing more beautiful than a woman who's not afraid to be her natural self. Now, another girl happened to mention that so this person who's constantly using makeup, talking about makeup, is actually being hypocritical by saying that a girl who's not afraid to be her natural self and there's not something more beautiful than that. So coming back, what I was trying to ask you is that, is there, if somebody says your natural self is without makeup, why do you need makeup to feel good, or why do you need to take an extra effort to into your appearance, which is apparently skin deep and la-di-da, why do you need to do that to feel good?
Because sometimes, just like when you wake up feeling like shit, you wake up looking like shit. It happens. That's the truth. You know, if I get 11 hours of sleep, not 11, maybe 9. If I get 9 hours of sleep, I wake up looking like a rock star, feeling like a rock star. But hey, guess what? I don't get to sleep that long every day. Sometimes I have to go to bed at 2 a.m. and wake up at 5:30 because I have to go to shoot, you know. And then I may feel like shit, but I can't look like shit because people are paying to see my face on screen. And I have to conceal my dark circles and blah, blah, blah. And that is my professional
ethic.
And it's also, it's the whatever, it goes along with the job. But I'm sure that applies to women who have to go to office as well, you know. They might, and well, maybe it helps them feel better about themselves. It's the same thing. Why do some people wear heels and some people, they don't wear heels? I'm tall. I still like to wear heels. It just makes me feel like I can take on the world today. It's just a thing. I have no idea why, because I definitely don't need to wear heels, but I like to wear heels. So maybe in that same way.
I know. Especially when you wear heels, I'm looking at you like, hello, Andrea.
And people are like, you don't need to wear heels. You're already so tall. So in the same way, people might say, you don't need to wear makeup. You're already so beautiful. But, well, if a little dab of lipstick makes your face pop and a little dab of mascara makes your face pop, go for it. That's my go-to thing. If I feel like I'm looking a bit drab, I just put a little concealer on my here and a little color, and then I pinch my cheeks a little.
Hey!
And some mascara and I'm done.
I like this pinches.
It works. See, have you noticed? It's a little pink.
Oh my God!
That's it.
How smart!
Yeah, it works.
Ding, 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 ding.
Okay,
ding.
Not for everybody, but okay.
It works for you, clearly. Yeah. You have this.
I have the pink undertones.
Yes, you do,
you
actually.
So, but you don't have to pinch your cheeks.
Okay.
Okay, another little cheap trick I do is, because I am, again, I reiterate, when I'm very lazy when it comes to makeup, I have a lip tint. So I put the lip tint here, and then I put a little bit like this, and I do that.
Yeah.
And then, maybe I should show it to everybody.
Yes, you should.
I should find
the next video with her will be a demonstration of all her makeup tips and tricks. Ellathi indha video la sollarama content varu nee vera.
Okay.
Continue.
Continue what?
This thing, whatever you did.
Yeah, that's all. That's it. This is a great thing like that. I don't know.
So actually that's also a lymphatic drainage massage of a thing. I've seen it on Instagram on some people.
Wow.
People do this pinching thing. They also pinch around the lips so that the lips look more plump.
Or you can kiss somebody. That works too.
Okay. I'm just PG. Rated PG. Kids watch this channel as well. Okay, children. Okay.
Well, it's true. Absolutely. Happy hormones are very good for the skin.
Yes.
That includes also just plain exercise at the gym.
Okay.
I mean, you want your views, right?
Yes.
I'm just saying. Any form of exercise works. Just saying.
Okay. All right. All right. I am trying to compose myself. Okay, what is this one indulgent thing with regard to skincare or makeup? What is that one thing that you actually love to spend on for yourself? It could be a bag, it could be makeup, it could be... What do you really like? I think I have
shoes.
An answer to this. Shoes and bags.
Shoes, mostly shoes. I love shoes. And bags. Bags are lovely too.
Okay, which one's your favorite bag so far?
My Chanel.
Chanel which? The boy bag?
Yeah.
Or the classic flap?
Which is the one I have? I don't know their names. I just know what they look like.
Okay.
But the next item on my list is the Birkin. I want to get the Birkin.
Dude, $22,000. Isn't it?
Oh. Does anyone want to buy a Birkin?
Yes. If somebody wants to buy Andrea.
Please subscribe to.
Hey, if you subscribe to my channel.
Yeah, please subscribe to Chinmay's channel.
Huh.
And DM her.
Okay.
And we'll let you know which Birkin you want.
Okay. She needs the Birkin. Okay. This is an ad for Andrea wanting a Birkin, which is about $22,000. If you're kind enough to get her one, that's all you'll get. You can give her the bag.
You can have the pleasure of making me happy.
Okay. By giving her the bag. So that is that. Thank you very much, Andrea. This was... fantastic. And if you still want to buy Andrea Birkin, please leave me a DM on Instagram or leave a comment down below. And yes, as she said, subscribe.
That's B-I-R-K.
Okay, see you next time. Bye.